And you only need to add it all the way up to the top, and I'm spilling, I'm spilling, I'm spilling. Oh, oh, okay, cute.
Hi, my name is Salem Kaplani. I'm a BuzzFeed producer, food lover, amateur chef, and I'm making this video because lately, it's really hard to go to the grocery store. So many of us are in our homes, currently on lockdown due to COVID-19. A lot of us are reacting to this in different ways. Some of us are panicking internally, and some of us are just completely chill, while some of us are panicking at the grocery store.
Many stores are experiencing supply shortages.
Shelves are empty and the lines are long.
Buying more than you need means that others may be left without.
I feel like at the beginning of like when people started to take this really seriously, I was hanging out with a friend and we went to Trader Joe's to go get some food. There was nothing. Freezer aisle empty. Pantry aisle empty. Cheese aisle empty. I literally walked out of the store with a baguette and condiments. What am I supposed to do with that? So the problem that I have with this is that there isn't actually a food shortage happening. And if things continue to go in this direction, it could actually lead to prices going up for items that are harder to find in stores. I don't know, man. I'm hungry, so I'm gonna go to the grocery store and see if I can make myself dinner tonight. Let's go.
Okay, I'm back from the grocery store. So we arrived at the grocery store and we had to stand in line. And at first I was like freaked out because I thought that that meant that there were a lot of people in the store. But what I realized is that it's actually because they kind of were letting more people in as people came out. It was so much easier for us to distance ourselves from each other, so I actually really appreciated the way that they were handling it. When I got there, I noticed that there was a lot of stuff missing. Flour and eggs were really hard to find, so that's gonna rule out all of the recipes that I can do with those. The produce section and the vegetable section were completely untouched. So with my leftover grocery store food, I'm gonna try to make an appetizer, a main meal, and a dessert for myself tonight.
Okay, so we're here in my makeshift kitchen, and the first thing that we're gonna make is probably the last thing that we're gonna eat, dessert.
Since fruit seems to be really readily available at a lot of grocery stores, I thought it'd be cool to make a fruit popsicle. It's great because it's pretty much just water and fruit and honey. So I'm just gonna start by cutting up some strawberries because this is going to go inside of the ice pops. I'm gonna try to get them a little bit small. And of course, make sure you wash your fruit. Off to a good start so far.
Okay, so at the store, I found little ice pop trays. It's cute, they've got about 6 in them, so I'm going to put the strawberries inside of these, along with some blueberries.
So I say just add as many as until you feel like you got enough fruit in there.
Next, we're gonna add a little bit of honey and a little bit of water. So this is just kind of to sweeten it up a little bit.
Then after adding the honey, we're gonna add some water. And you only need to add it all the way up to the top, and I'm spilling, I'm spilling, I'm spilling. Oh, oh. Okay, cute. Then we're gonna put the little icicle pops on it to close it up.
Okay, so now I'm gonna put these in the freezer for about 5 hours and then we're gonna get started with the rest of the food.
So at the grocery store, I was able to find some shrimp, garlic, I was able to find some bread. There was mayonnaise, I was able to find some butter, which was great. So I think I'm gonna make a shrimp toast appetizer to start with. What I like about this recipe is that it doesn't really need a lot of ingredients. The main thing that you do need is the shrimp.
Now, a lot of times when I've seen this, it's fried shrimp toast. We don't really have eggs and we don't really have flour because all of that is gone from the grocery stores. So right now, I wanna try to bake it. So the first thing I'm gonna do is take the shrimp and cut them into little pieces. And you only need about 6 ounces of this shrimp. Try not to cut my fingers. So I'm just gonna go back in and make sure that it's as finely chopped up as it can be. So now we have a proper plate of shrimp mush. So now that the shrimp is cut up, we're gonna add some ingredients. I'm gonna add 3 tablespoons of mayo, 3 tablespoons of butter, melted of course, and then 3 cloves of garlic just to give it some flavor. I'm not a tasty producer, guys. Last minute, I kinda thought that I wanted to add a little bit more spice to it. So along with the mayo, I'm gonna add some sriracha. In addition to those ingredients, I'm gonna add some salt and pepper. Okay, now we're gonna mix all these ingredients up. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is spread this mixture onto a slice of bread. So you're gonna wanna get the bread ready to go in the oven by spreading the mixture that we just made on top of it.
I want this toast to be thick.
I want it to be thick with some shrimps, okay? So we're just gonna bedazzle this on. Okay, so I'm gonna bake this for about 15 to 20 minutes until we can see that the top is a nice golden brown, and then we'll move on to the next meal.
Hi. Hello.
Hello. I'm sorry.
So for the main meal, I've decided that I want to make a vegetable buddha bowl. So at the grocery store, I was able to find a lot of vegetables, and I was also able to find lentils. I'm gonna make the buddha bowl comprised of cauliflower, broccoli, sweet potatoes, spring mix of kale and spinach, and lentils. All of these things really can be subbed out for other things. Like any vegetables that you can find in the grocery store, I think that it's okay to throw them in. Now, if you're not able to find lentils, that's perfectly fine. You can swap them out for some other sort of protein.
I found a recipe for a buddha bowl on tasty.com. So the first thing I'm gonna do is get all these ingredients into the oven. Sweet potato, some broccoli, cauliflower. So first we're gonna drizzle some oil onto it. 1/3 of a cup of oil. So we're gonna add some salt and pepper to taste. So now I'm gonna take these away and put them in the oven for about 10 minutes. So after the vegetables have been in the oven for about 10 minutes, I'm gonna take them out and add the greens. And once again, gonna add some oil. We're just gonna mix all that oil in and make sure that it's lathered in there, and then I'm gonna put it back in the oven for about 10 minutes. So over on the stove, I'm also heating up some lentils, so I'll be adding those to the buddha bowl too. Okay, we did it. The meal is done, everything is in the oven or in the freezer, and they're about ready to come out, and I'm about ready to eat. So let's do this, and let's reveal what I've made. Okay, so I have my beautiful 3-course meal here. I'm so happy and so excited to eat this. My dog is desperately trying to get in here.
Hi.
So let's start with the shrimp toast. This is way better than I was expecting it to be. I wanted to use a different bread like sourdough or baguette or something like that, but this actually really works. This was definitely a success. Okay, one more bite. Moving on. Next. We have the buddha bowl. Like I said, I put lentils in this, a little protein. Let's just eat it. I'm into this one. It's nice, you know, because it's a healthy thing. How can you feel bad about yourself after you eat freaking cauliflower? Cauliflower, so healthy. I'm glad they left the vegetables. Y'all are missing out. Dang, guys, I made this. Wow. Okay, another shrimp toast. So last, but certainly not least, we have the fruit popsicles. Oh no. I'm so sorry, okay? Am I bothering you? No, people are gonna yell at me if I feed you something. You can't feed dogs anything. Let's just try it out. Let's see how it works. I freaking did that. If I could do something differently with this, I'm noticing that a lot of the honey kind of sank to the bottom. So a lot of the honey is here, but like not so much like here. But it still tastes really good. My favorite things were the shrimp toast and the ice pops. Not because the buddha bowl was bad, it was just like, I know I can make this, like it's a bunch of things kind of mixed together. Long story short, if you find yourself in a situation where you're at the grocery store and the eggs and the flour and the milk are all gone, just try to make some of these other things with some vegetables and fruits, whatever else you can find, and hopefully the stores will restock themselves before you get back there next time. Okay, bye. Oh, I touched my face.